touching yourself to that video we made a month ago. You a freak and your cover's blown. How you told me innocent and that to you, I'll never know. Fuck it, girl, I'm about whatever though. Yeah, I guess a nigga just believe in you and that's proof for you.
Hey y'all, it's Kyla back with another video. So y'all see that I have a two-part wig. It was a 30-inch two-part wig. So y'all see I'm just going in with the shampoo just to get all like the yellow stuff at the blonde wig. So when I put the color on it, it'll be like more pretty. You can actually see it. But yeah, I'm just going in and washing the hair with shampoo first before I put the color in. Now y'all see I get all the yellow out her hair. So now I'm finna just start dyeing her wig. And I use about like three types of different blues because for her birthday she chose to like do like a multi type of the blue, and she told me to leave like some blonde pieces out, but the blonde pieces you can't really see because it was getting colored with all the other pieces that dyed blue. So yeah, y'all just go watch me dye this wig, and this is speedy up, so it won't take all day. So on this part, my friend, she gave me like an inspiration picture, like how she wanted her hair, and I'm gonna put that in the corner right there. But she wanted her hair like this, so I tried to like put the front of the hair how exactly the picture was. It wasn't gonna be the same colors, but how exactly the picture was. I knew it wouldn't go turn out how exactly it was, but I was just trying to make it more similar, if y'all get what I'm saying. So yes, this is what I'm doing with this part of the front of the wig. If y'all was confused on why I was like dyeing in three different colors. Yeah, so on this part, y'all just see like after when I put the dye on the wig. So this is how the front part looked when the dye was still on there before I washed it off. And now y'all just want to see me wash the hair with purple shampoo on the hair. And use silicone to make the hair more shinier so it can get a little shine look when I take the pictures of her hair and stuff. And y'all would see, I know y'all saw that little one spot of blonde in the back of her. That was because I tried to leave like most of the blonde piece out because she wanted me to leave like a little bit of the blonde piece out. But all of them kept getting covered by the dye, so they looked like kind of dingy blue kind of ish. So you really not gonna see no other blonde piece but that one. But yeah, y'all just see me washing the hair with purple shampoo to make the colors more lighter, and then washing it with silicone so the hair could be more shinier. Now y'all see I'm just gonna go in with some crystal clear and the silicone mix to make the hair shiny. So yeah, the crystal clear actually works only if you had the silicone for me, because I had just the crystal clear one time and it did not work. So make sure if y'all trying to make the hair shine after y'all wash the wig or dye or anything, get crystal clear and the silicone mix. Thank you. Okay, yeah, so this is the birthday girl. So she had a tea party we installed. Y'all saw the dye process. Now this is the installment process. So I usually do like 2 layers of glue. It depends on how long I feel like they gonna keep it on, or how long they say they gonna keep it on. But she gonna keep it on for like a whole week or 2, maybe 3. But yeah, so I just do like 2 rows of dotted lines. So like I won't have to like just do all across. I do 2 rows of dotted line because it just helped me like keep like where I'm gonna put the wig and then where her actual hairline is. So it just keep those two from each other. Now y'all see me putting her wig on and just making sure that her lace is melted in the glue before I put the lace wig on, rubbing it in the glue, making sure it stick and it stay. So y'all see I'm just going in and putting lace band on her hair so her lace can be real melty and stick to the lace glue. Please don't mind her naps in the bag, you know, just this irrelevant. But yeah, I'm just putting the lace band on her hair to make sure her lace is stuck down to the glue very good and tight. So I put the lace band over. Now y'all just see me brushing her hair out, getting ready to lay her the front part of her hair down with the wave stick and then high comb it so it can be like real flat. So when I take the lace band off, I won't have to really worry about nothing but just parting her hair and high comb it the part around the part. Thank you. Now y'all see me just hot combing her hair to make sure the front of her hair is flat. And so when I take the elastic band off, it will look like her hair is melting into her skin. I won't have to really worry about nothing but parting her hair and doing the other stuff. Now y'all see I'm just cutting the lace off her hair into like 4 sections just to like separate it, so I won't just have to cut like the whole lace off. It's just easier for me. I don't know about y'all, but it's just easier for me to cut the lace off better. Now y'all see as I'm cutting her lace off, I'm using an eyebrow archer, because when I use the eyebrow archer, it gives the lace like a more natural look. Like when y'all know, when y'all cut the lace off with scissors or anything like that, you have to go in a zigzag motion anyway. But with the eyebrow archer, you don't have to go in a zigzag motion because it already gives that natural look when you cut it off. So cutting off the lace with the eyebrow archer is way better than cutting off a regular scissors. So y'all just see me going in with the eyebrow archer, cutting the rest of her lace off. So now I do that. After I did that, y'all see I'm just trying to make sure her hair is laid, and then I put the elastic band over her hair to like remelt the lace again, so it won't have a little white look after I take it off again. So yeah, I'm just going in with the elastic band again and just melting the lace. Now y'all see I'm just finna start pulling out her baby hairs to her liking, how many ever she wants. I do like 4 sessions of baby hairs depending on like what's the kind of style she getting or how many is it that she wants, so it won't be that many baby hairs as last time as I usually do on her hair. Now y'all see I'm just going back in with the hot comb. I'm trying to make sure everything flat before I lay her baby hairs. Thank you. Now y'all just see I'm going in with the Westie trying to make her hair flat before I do her baby hairs. Now y'all just see I'm just flattering the back of her hair in pieces so everything can look straight. And then I'm gonna do the same in the front. Y'all see that I'm done flattering all the pieces of her hair. Y'all just see I'm going back in with the hot comb trying to make sure everything is flat before I do her baby hairs. So now when y'all see me do the baby hairs, y'all gonna see me go in with the hot comb and flattering them. I mean, hot comb them before I start styling them. And then I cut into like a certain angle to where how I know when I do the baby hair, it's going to look right when I swoop it. So I just cut it to a certain angle. I don't just cut it out of nowhere. So yeah, y'all just going to see me do that to the baby hairs. And yes, I also go in with got to be glue to do the baby hairs. I don't use the clear one because it doesn't work. So the yellow bottle works better than that. So I just go in with got to be glue and start doing her baby hairs. And please don't mind my sister in the video. She was just helping me trying to get my stuff to get in cleaned up after I got done doing my friend hair. So now y'all just see me going in the middle of her part to put some makeup right there to hide like all the, you know, discoloration or whatever. So I just go in with some makeup and put it in between her part and around her edges just to make it look like more of her skin. And now on the side right there, y'all see that her edges look like it's coming out her skin. This what that makeup is for. Yes, this why I always use it after I get done doing anybody hair. But yeah, thank y'all for watching. I really hope y'all like this video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications for more hair videos like these. And thank y'all for watching. Bye.